else involved in keeping running in the centre?
It's not just it's really all about caring for the animals. Animals can't clean themselves. So I'd probably say about 75% of your job is actually cleaning, okay? The rest of it is caring for the animals, medicating them, feeding them, grooming them and giving them the daily exercise, okay? We're also talking about socialising and stuff like that as well. Where some of the animals we get in here have had not the best upbringing, so we need a bit more work to get them into a homeable state of mind. Would be quite happy to live in a home with a family, okay? A lot of the work involves is like maintenance and stuff like that as well. I mean, we cut all our own grass and everything like that as well, and do all the weeding in here, clean all the windows. We don't have a window cleaner, we do it in here. So it's really maintenance. We also pick up animals from other centres, and we have a scheme Half Paws Will Travel. So we're always out in the vans, transporting animals about to different places, picking up animals from police stations and stuff like that as well. And there's also a lot of, possibly giving tours to colleges, stuff like that as well, maybe partake in. So really that's it. Just before people go on holiday, kind of the fair, I suppose, and just before Christmas can be quite busy. A lot of people fail to get boarding accommodation for their animals before they go on holiday, so they think it's acceptable just to put that animal out in the street, okay? Before Christmas as well, you get a lot of people putting out the old to bring in the new, I suppose, putting out all the old animals to get all the new animals in for Christmas presents and stuff like that. So that's the busiest times, but to be honest with you, you're busy really all year round, but I would say the two periods are the busiest times. Staff at Bull Terriers, we get lots of them in the centre. Nothing to do with the breed of the dog. The breed of the dog, they're cracking me dogs. That's the same as every other dog, as long as you socialise them well as a puppy and bring them up well. It's just, obviously, they're kind of known as a status symbol now. And it's maybe these people are getting them, then realising what it's going to take to care for that animal, and then they just put them out. So I would say, probably staffies, lurchers, greyhounds. We get quite a lot of them in. Staffies, I mean, if you go up to the kennels now, you'll probably notice probably about 70% of the dogs are staffies, cross staffies, but they're great wee dogs. They should consider the accommodation they're in, their working life, how long that animal's going to be left for, how much time they can spend exercising that animal, training that animal, how long the animal's going to live for as well. They've got any allergies as well. We've got a lot of people that have got animals and they end up allergic to it and they just bring it in and dump it. We've got a lot of people that take animals on, take puppies on, and they're out working 12-hour shifts. We get a lot of people that take border collies on and they're living in seven-storey high flat and they're out working full-time. The dogs are just not suitable for that type of environment unless they're getting loads and loads of exercise. So really that's it. Your environment, your hours that you're just willing to put into the animal, how long that animal lives for, that's what I would say. The advantage of us is our animals are fully vet checked with a vet, okay? They all get a first vaccine when they come in here. They're microchipped, they're neutered or spayed. You get 4 weeks free insurance with them, okay? The good thing is as well that we assess our animals when we come in here. Now, we can't give you 100% guarantee what they're going to be like when they get into an environment, but we can give you a fairly good idea of what that animal's going to be like. We also assess the people. We try and match up that animal, not just dogs, but cats and rabbits and stuff as well. We match up the animal with the person, okay? So that's the bonuses, I would say, instead of just going off on a whim and saying, oh, I'll go and buy a puppy there.